The goal of this lab was to give a fixed position satellite dish the ability to rotate. The importance of this is quite simple. If a poor signal is coming from the source you need, going on top of the roof to move the position of the dish is not very efficient. It's not even safe for that matter. So we wanted to create a way to position a satellite based on an input by an operator. It will be used to aim at geostationary satellites to monitor atmospheric effect on signals. Since the direction of the desired signal is known, we will be able to position the dish in order to accurately aim at the intended satellite. A Freescale FRDM KL25Z microcontroller was used to control the position of the disk. The online compiler embed was used to communicate with the microcontroller.
The mount on which the positioner was placed was mostly pre-made. The part that was created was the acrylic plate that would be mounted around the axis of the positioner and extend out to the motor. Here's where the design portion takes place. We decided that the positioner would move by placing a rubber stopper on the shaft of the motor. The motor was placed at the end of the acrylic plate we created, so as the motor spins, the rubber stopper will actuate the plate, thereby rotating the dish. Now that the rotation of the dish has been determined, we will move on to the question of how to move it to a desired degree. This is where the circuit and microcontroller are introduced. In our circuit, we start off with an operational amplifier. A comparator op-amp was used to compare static voltage with the voltage from the encoder signal. The static voltage was adjusted using a trim pod in order to adjust sensitivity to match a level just below the maximum voltage from the encoder signal. When the voltage of the signal is greater than the source voltage, the output of the comparator will send digital signal to the microcontroller to tell it if the encoder is currently seeing a reflective or non-reflective surface. The code running in the microcontroller is quite simple. It takes in the digital value of the output of the comparator op-amp, read as either a 1 or a 0, and tracks when the signal goes from off to on. It then increments or decrements a counter variable on the rising edge of the digital signal based on the current direction of the motor. The direction of the motor is determined by comparing the current degree to the input degree for the terminal.
Once the microcontroller has processed its needed information, it sends a signal to an H-bridge chip to control the direction of the motor. This allows the motor to have direction control using a single integrated circuit, driven by two digital output signals from the microcontroller. There is an LED attached to each signal line to tell the operator which direction the motor should be moving.
If the desired degree is higher than the current degree, the microcontroller will turn on two opposite corner switches in the H-bridge, so the motor will run forward. On the other hand, if the desired degree is lower than the current degree, the microcontroller will turn on the other two switches, so the motor will run in reverse.
As the motor turns the acrylic plate, the arrowhead sensor passes over alternating reflective and non-reflective surfaces. This provides a relatively periodic sinusoidal waveform on the output of the phototransistor. This signal is passed into the comparator, which gives an output that is either on or off, with an active voltage of 4 volts. This translates the sinusoid seen by the arrowhead sensor into a square wave, which is easier to manipulate in the microcontroller.
This square wave can be seen in comparison to the sinusoid using an oscilloscope. This footage shows that even a small shift in the analog voltage translates to an immediate drop in the digital signal.
This square wave is seen by the program and counts on the rising edge of the wave. The counter can be seen in the terminal, counting the numbers of marks seen on the arrowhead sensor.
The final product turns with a maximum range of approximately 35 degrees with a tolerance of plus or minus 3/5 of a degree. Both of these figures could be improved by building a larger acrylic plate to increase the rotational range, die cutting or 3D printing an encoder plate with more consistent marks, or relying more heavily on computer-aided design rather than hand-cut materials.
The final product was tested using a laser-level whiteboard and some basic trigonometry. This test proved that the dish positioner was able to turn to the desired degree within the prescribed tolerance.